synopsis and you being welcome back to my channel. And in this video I'm going to be showing you guys how to stop your scalp from itching like crazy. If you're like me and you have a problem with your scalp itching whenever you have braids or any kind of new style in your hair, I got you, girl. I'm gonna give you so many tips. All these tips are very important. Lots of them work together, some of them work separately. The first tip is you want to keep your hair moisturized at all times. Now, I'm not saying you're going to moisturize your hair in the braids the same way that you do in when your hair is just out, whether it's natural or relaxed or whatever. You just need to moisturize your hair by occasionally spritzing a little braid spray and then sealed in with an oil, especially closest to your scalp. The reason why you want to do that is because your hair itches usually because it's very dry, it has some dandruff, or you're sort of like dehydrated, and the only way to combat that is, of course, to moisturize your scalp. So the more moisturized your scalp is, the less itchy it's going to be. So the second tip is to wash your hair. Now, if you guys don't know how to wash your hair in braids, when it's wash day for me, I'm going to film a video so I'll teach you how to do it, but for now I'm just going to explain it. So there's two different types of ways that you can wash your hair. The first way is almost the same way that you wash your normal hair, except you will put the shampoo in a spray bottle and mix it with water so that it's not pure and gets stuck anywhere in your braids. And you're going to spritz this on your scalp and sort of massage the shampoo in the same direction as you would when you're putting an oil, not to generate any frizz. And then you just go ahead and rinse that out, put in a leave-in conditioner that's like mixed with water so that also it doesn't stay and cause buildup on your scalp. And then you rinse all that out and just squeeze all the excess water out, leave that to dry, and then proceed to oil your scalp. That's the first way. The second way is to go ahead and get a hot washcloth or face cloth. Just dip it in some hot water, not blazing hot. You should be able to hold the face cloth. And then just put a little bit of shampoo on it and then just rub down your scalp, like on every single area of your scalp. And then once that is dry, you go ahead and squeeze it, get a clean face wash, a face towel, and soak it in some clean water, and then go ahead and wipe down everywhere where you put the shampoo on your scalp, and then go ahead and oil your scalp. That's just like a quick wash kind of thing that you can do if you don't want to go under the water and wet all your braids. So those are two different types of washing your hair that are going to prevent your hair from getting dry and causing itching. The next way is to oil your scalp with essential oils that prevent itching, bacteria, and dandruff. And the number one oil for this I recommend is tea tree oil. And then the one that really soothes your scalp and really helps you feel refreshed and combats the itching is peppermint oil. So I always recommend using them together, but if you only have one, you can only use one. And if you only purchase one, I suggest tea tree oil, as much as I love peppermint, because tea tree oil is also going to kill excess bacteria and all that kind of stuff. Now, because I said use tea tree oil and peppermint, I don't mean get the little dropper or drop those pure on your scalp. Believe me, it will burn you, and if it doesn't burn you now, you're going to see the effects later. It might be 2 weeks from now, 2 months from now. Essential oils are always meant to be mixed with carrier oils, so when you use peppermint or tea tree oil, make sure you mix it in any light carrier oil of your choice. Coconut, jojoba, olive oil, avocado, almond oil. The choice is endless. Those are just the ones that I would suggest. So that really helps with the scalp. You can just do it maybe 3 times a week, depending on how itchy your hair is. So even if you're not moisturizing your hair, you can just do the plain oil on your scalp, and it really, really helps with itching. Now, this is a tip that goes hand in hand with literally almost all the tips that I've given. You can do this in conjunction with every single one of these tips or by itself, and this is to give yourself a scalp massage, because it will promote blood flow going to your scalp, and it will also promote your natural oils from coming through and preventing more of your itching. So if you do this with if you do this with an oil in your hair, like the tea tree or peppermint, that will just stimulate it more and you will feel the tingling even more. But if you don't use it with any oil or anything, it will still be very beneficial because it will warm your scalp and just really balance out everything going on your scalp, and it will really help your hair stop itching. So this one is my most important point, and there's two ways to go around it. This is the first way. The first way I'm going to tell you is you have to do this before you braided your hair, which is why I'm telling you while my hair is out. It's what you can do to the braiding hair before you do the braid. So if your hair is already braided, this part of the tip might be useless, but keep watching because I'm going to show you a way around it. And this is to dip your braiding hair in regular vinegar or apple cider vinegar. Honestly, there is no difference. I see no difference. So I just use regular vinegar because it is less than half the price of apple cider vinegar and I don't like wasting money. So the tip is to get warm water. Now, I've seen some other people say get hot water or something like that. Please don't get hot water. Don't get water that's just boiled or anything like that. And the reason is not because it's going to damage your hair per se, but if you guys use certain types of braiding hair, like the type I use, like Expression, then you know that when you dip it in hot water, it changes the texture, it makes it slightly lighter, it makes the hair smoother and more like a shiny kind of braid. So, and it also helps seal the braid once you're done braiding. So if you put it in water like that before you do it, it's like you're sealing the braid and doing everything you're supposed to do after you've already braided the hair. So please don't use boiling water. Use water that's hot, but hot enough for you to put your hand in for like a couple seconds and it won't burn you. Then you know that's the perfect temperature for the braiding hair. I'm going to insert a picture of what the bowl looked like because it was a night and I had no lighting, I couldn't show you. But what you're going to do is get a cup, one full cup of vinegar or apple cider vinegar, whatever you have on hand, and put it into, honestly, there's no measurement. Just get a dish that's big enough to completely soak all your braiding hair at once into the water, and then put a cup of water, mix it up in there. You should be able to mix it up with your hand so you know the water is not too hot, and then you can put your braiding hair in there. But also don't make it too warm because then it won't work. What's going to happen once you put the hair in, you can leave it in there for 15 to 20 minutes. I left mine in there actually for like an hour because I went to go and do something else and I just forgot about it. Actually, I think it was like 3 hours, but literally 20 minutes will do the job because once the water cools down, like there's not that much you can do. But what's going to happen is it's going to lift the film. There's a film that's put on all braiding hair to help it not tangle, to help it not smell bad or deteriorate in any way. And that chemical does a good job because before you get it, it's just like a preservative. Before you braid your hair, you need that in the hair to make sure it stays intact and looks good and looks shiny. But it's just like the coating on a shiny apple. It looks nice when you buy it, but when it's time to eat it, you have to rinse it off. So that's what the vinegar does. It lifts that film, and you're going to see in the picture that I put up here, there's like a white film that forms on top of the water. And once you see that white film, then you know that lots of the whatever coating was put on the hair has come off, and now you can rinse it. Not everyone is allergic to this film. Some people can braid their hair with the braiding hair and it doesn't make them itch and nothing happens. So it's possible that that might not be the reason why your hair is itching, but I discovered the last few times I braided my hair that that's why my hair would itch. And sometimes if you'd notice, some people would get red patches on their scalp, even if it's not really itching. That's also because of the protective film that's on the braiding hair. You want to make sure when you take the hair out, you rinse it under the tap. You can rinse it with something that has like something good smelling in it, like conditioner in it. But I mean, this is plastic. I really don't care to put conditioner or anything in it. And once it dries and you rinse out the water, there's completely no smell of the apple cider vinegar left. So once I took the hair out of the water, I let it dry overnight. And this is what it looks like. And you can see the hair is, it looks very, very light, of course. But the most important thing is if you look at it up close, all the texture is still there. The texture hasn't changed. It's not smooth or anything. This is the only one with the brand that I always use, which is Expression. And this is what it looks like. You're probably more familiar with this one. And you guys can see that all the texture in the entire part of the braid is still there. And that's what you want. If you see the texture change, it's not that you can't use the hair anymore, but it just won't be as effective and won't work as well in your hair as if you do it like this. So you guys can see it's not stacked together, it's not stuck together. Part of it is even still a little bit damp, but it just looks the same way it does when it's dry. And that is exactly what you want. And here is another tip within this tip. It is when you soak the hair in water, please leave it in the braid. If your hair does not come braided, whatever kind of hair you buy, if it's this kind of a long one, make sure you braid it up and tie it at the end. And the reason for this is braiding hair is synthetic, and you know synthetic hair tangles very badly. So if it tangles, basically everything's just ruined and you just wasted your money for that bundle of hair. So you want to make sure that your hair is braided. If it's short, it should be fine, but any long hair should be braided to prevent it from tangling. Now we're getting to the part where you probably forwarded to if your hair is already braided and you're thinking this tip is useless to me. Now is where it's going to be useful for you. Now, here's the second way around it. If you're saying, hey, the braids are already in my hair, this is why I'm in this video, my hair is already itching with the braids in it, I've got you. There's a way you can get around it. It's not as effective, but it's effective, but it is effective enough where you are. There's nothing you can do. The braids are in your head. You have to find a solution. So I'm going to give it to you now. You're going to get half a cup of apple cider vinegar or regular vinegar. Fill the other half with water. And again, it should be the same temperature of water. Very warm, not hot enough to burn you. But here you don't have to worry about it changing the texture, because if the braids are already in your hair, most likely all the texture stuff is already out of the way. But you don't want to burn your scalp or anything. So you're not going to add anything else. It's just going to be pure vinegar and water. And what you're going to do is you're going to spray your hair from your scalp till all the way up to the ends of your hair. You're going to spray it, completely soak it. If you can use the entire spray bottle, then do that. If you're worried about frizz, you gotta decide what you like more. A slight little bit of frizz or an itchy scalp for the whole month, it is up for you to decide. If not, you can lightly spray, but I suggest you douse your hair in this, okay? Spray all over, spray it, let it sit for like 30 minutes. If you don't like the smell, you're just gonna have to deal with it if you don't want your hair to itch, okay? After that, you're going to go under the water, rinse out your hair completely. Make sure you rinse everything out because you don't want your hair to be smelling like vinegar. And after you're done, then you can get your favorite leave-in conditioner, mix it with water, spray it on top of your hair, and get an oil that has a strong-ish scent that you don't mind. I love the smell of peppermint oil, so that would be my oil of choice. I would mix it into the spray. Spray that all over my hair and then just oil my scalp with like a regular, you know, just like a regular moisturize and seal situation. And then you're going to squeeze out all the excess product, leave your hair to dry, the vinegar smell will be gone, your hair is going to be smelling good, you're not going to have an itchy scalp, you're going to be living your life ready to do your ish. If you guys are interested in seeing any other videos about box braids or anything else on my channel, make sure you see them. They're going to be on the screen here. If you aren't subscribed to this channel and you didn't give this video a thumbs up in the beginning, what are you waiting for, girl? Go ahead and do that, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!